Welcome to this workshop on studio monitors and room acoustics. To make your mixes work well everywhere, you should use a studio monitor. But I would like to explain that a good studio monitor alone is not the solution to your problems. A studio monitor should be linear, so all frequencies must be balanced. A look at the technical data and the frequency response shows our studio monitor can do that. Perfect. Highly motivated, we set up our loudspeaker setup and listen and do a measurement. And what's that? This is our frequency response? What happened to the beautiful straight line from the technical data, please? First question, where does the straight line come from? Or better asked, when can our studio monitor do that? The answer? The studio monitor can do this without the influence of a room. This is called free field or anechoic chamber. So the curve only shows that the speaker was constructed to work linearly without disturbing influences. Anechoic chambers are complex to build, and you don't want to be there for long either. The same applies to a so-called free field. So whether we like it or not, we have to accept that there will be a room around our loudspeaker. And the room can, unfortunately, make our frequency response look like this. Why? The main problems are massive walls, the floor and the ceiling. They reflect the sound our speakers emit. This means that not only the direct sound from the loudspeakers reaches our ears, but also many reflections. And these reflections lead to boosts or dips in certain frequency ranges. At the same time, it is important to know that only high frequencies are emitted in a directional manner. Already towards the mid-frequencies, the radiation gets wider and wider. In the bass range, a loudspeaker radiates omnidirectionally. So the bass energy is distributed throughout the room and is reflected on every massive wall. One possibility now is the installation of absorbers. Materials such as mineral wool extract energy from sound and convert it into heat. The amount of reflections can be significantly reduced. The disadvantage? You need a lot of absorbing material to get bass frequencies under control. In order to achieve better results, especially in the bass range, there is another possibility that we would like to show you in the next video. Smart Active Monitoring. SAM for short.